This is the scene at San Francisco's newest Filipino restaurant, Uncle Tito's. It starts with co-owner Paulo Dayao taking orders at the register. His brother, chef, and co-owner Vince Dayao prepares the food. And when it's all ready to go, their childhood friend and co-owner, Joseph Acasabas, serves it right to your table. Here, it's not just about good Filipino food, it's about sharing the culture and strong family ties.
We grew up in houses and parents with true Filipino values. And that goes with the manners, the culture, the humor, and especially the cuisine. So we're adding all the flavors we grew up with from our parents and adding our own influence as growing up as American kids.
In 2016, Paulo and Joseph operated a bartending service called Straight Up. But they say the missing piece was Vince's culinary skills. So they banded together, but then the coronavirus pandemic hit. After offering and delivering quarantine CC kits and Baon boxes all over the Bay Area, the trio knew how to evolve their business.
We kind of pivoted, took a step back, kind of reevaluated what kind of brand we wanted to do. And eventually we came up with Uncle Tito. And from there it kind of was seamless. Like the brand identity clicked and it felt easy too. You know, we weren't trying to be a certain niche. We were just being ourselves.
And so Uncle Tito's was born, now operating out of San Francisco's Filipino Cultural District, Soma Pilipinas. They offer traditional Filipino dishes with their own unique takes, like their pork sisig, which can be served over French fries with a seal of approval from the patriarch of the Dayao family.
I would test batch with him like 30 types of sisig, you know, growing up. Be like, and he's very stern. He'd be like, yeah, that was whack. It wasn't good. Yeah, so then finally got to a point where it was consistent and like he really liked it too. So like that's one of the ode and there's a lot of like story to it.
Lechon kawali, laing wontons, and adobo garlic wings are also customer favorites. Uncle Tito's also offers Filipino-inspired refreshers like spicy mango calamansi, ube almond milk, and pandan sweet tea, as well as desserts like their Milo banana cream lumpia.
Growing up, we drank that a lot. So we're trying to make a new lumpia in a sense where it's like, it's fun, kind of pertains to everyone too, and it's like a sweet lumpia.
The guys behind Uncle Tito say they are proud to be part of this new wave of Philam entrepreneurs trying to elevate Filipino cuisine by honoring their history and looking forward to what it can bring to mainstream America. Ramel Quinclara, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.